Here's the story of a home at law school that was just trying to make it through the year. All of them were really sad because of COVID. Their friends they can't get near. Here's the story of a club called Law Revue who were trying to produce an at-home show. All of them were really scared to make a bad one. They were afraid it'd blow. Till the one day when the club had an idea, and they knew that it would be a big time crunch. We thought we have to make this funny. And that's the way we all became the GW Bunch. The GW Bunch. The GW Bunch. That's the way we became the GW Bunch.
Welcome back to Legal Celebrity Jeopardy, Separation of Powers Edition. My name is Ken Jennings. I hold the record for the longest winning streak in Jeopardy history. Tonight's theme is Tomorrow's Leaders Today. Our contestants will represent each branch of the U.S. government. On to our first contestant, who will represent the legislative branch, a lawyer, insatiable tryhard, and the gunner who everyone wants to see slip up, Senator Cory Booker. Oh, that's too bad, Senator Booker. It seems like you still can't connect with your audience. What's this? Someone new seems to be hijacking Senator Booker's spot. It can't be.
Good evening, Ken. It's Mayor Pete. I'm calling in using fine, secure American technology, a Dominion voting machine. It's great to be here tonight to take part in such a distinctly American institution.
Excuse me, Mayor Peter, I don't think we had you booked. Also, the theme for tonight's show is Tomorrow's Leaders Today. How do you fit in the mix?
It's Mayor Pete, and I serve the executive as seventh in line from the presidency.
Oh dear. Well, I guess you'll have to represent the executive then. Would you mind changing your screen name? You're no longer...
A mayor? In fact, I'm America's Mayor, Ken. Soy el alcalde de los Estados Unidos. Together, we can lead today into a new tomorrow. Imagine a progressive future where everything I say means nothing, but everything you hear means everything.
Except for the Spanish, I have absolutely no idea what you're talking about. Our next guest hails from the hallowed halls of fictional law firm Pearson Spector Litt and the shade cast from Buckingham Palace. Please welcome the fake lawyer from Suits and our contestant for the judiciary, Meghan Markle.
Greetings. It's so good to be on the show tonight, Ken. I'm afraid Meghan couldn't make it tonight because she had to make another appearance on... another show. Well, it's probably for the best. At least I'm still a member of the government.
Miss Middleton, I'm not sure how you or Mr. Buttigieg gained access to the password or meeting ID for this Zoom, but I've got to say that this is...
Silly, I'm also calling in from a Dominion voting machine.
Well, I see. Anyway, moving on. Our next guest, representing the legislative branch, is a hotshot, fresh-faced freshman congressman from North Carolina, and certainly not that girl you went to high school with, Madison Cawthorn. Representative Cawthorn, I'm glad you could spare some time from spewing complete nonsense to join us today.
Anything to own the libs, Ken.
Okay, then. Let's present tonight's categories. First is Con Law 1. Second is the Roaring Twenties, could be 1920 or 2020. Third is people listed by Wikipedia as notable alumni from Patrick Henry College. Fourth is whodunit. Fifth is objection irrelevant. Ms. Middleton, you've been selected to go first.
I'll choose objection irrelevant for 500.
This branch of government historically passed laws, but more recently has become what some describe as Hollywood for ugly people.
Ooh, What is the British monarchy?
No, and I'm surprised you'd say that. Mr. Buttigieg?
What is American politics, whose core is rotten like an apple, but not Indiana apples, which are produced widely throughout the state, a bounty connected to the rest of this great nation by hard-working truckers driving on American soil?
Mr. Buttigieg, please. The answer was Congress. Let's just move on to the next category, whatever. Mr. Cawthorn, the choice is yours.
Yeah, Ken, I'm not one to look a gift horse in the mouth. I'll take people listed on Wikipedia as notable alumni from Patrick Henry College.
Right. This noted law student and moot court star graduated from Patrick Henry College in 2016, attends what is considered a prestigious law school in a major city, and is a model for Body by V.
Madison Cawthorn.
No, no. You didn't even graduate, Mr. Cawthorn. The answer is Teresa Scanlon, who I'm sure everyone remembers as Miss America 2011. Mr. Buttigieg, maybe you can pick a category someone on the stage can actually answer.
I'll take a whodunit for 1,000.
All right, well, the answer is Daily Double. Here to present today's Daily Double answer is Gary Johnson's one-time pick for the Supreme Court and a pathblazer of GW's Black Box Theater to JD Pipeline. Please welcome Professor Jonathan Turley.
Hello, Ken. Jonathan can't make it tonight. I ran into him at Fox and he asked me to sub in.
Did he give you the ID and password? That was against his contract.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm calling in from a Dominion voting machine to demonstrate how compromised they are and that this election was stolen.
Let's just, whatever, continue on.
This person satisfied the Brandenburg standard for incitement, committed high crimes and misdemeanors, and attended at least one restaurant in DC.
Who is Donald Trump?
What a hateful, deceitful fake news answer.
Ms. Conway, that's exactly how you answer a Jeopardy question.
You think you can deplatform me, Ken? The Biden administration has already taken the blonde out of my hair. I'll be damned if I let you and this stupid show take anything else from me. I actually have to jump on Twitter to deal with some family problems.
Well, that was fucked. Let's just continue to Final Jeopardy. The category is Constitutional Law 1. Still a practicing lawyer today and still creating precedential cases, such as in his recent representation of a wine bar against the Trump Hotel. This GW law professor wrote every single case students read in Con Law 1.
It's obvious.
Appropriate that time. Okay, Representative Cawthorn, we'll start with you. Let's see what you wrote. No. Representative Cawthorn, the answer is not Professor Michael Avenatti.
That's fake news and the product of the Democratic machine.
Cry more, Lib. Moving on to Miss Middleton. You wrote Atticus Finch. Ugh. Unfortunately, Professor Finch wrote all the cases for Con Law 2, Miss Middleton. Better luck next time, Scout.
But I did read the book at St. Andrews, you know, where I met my husband, the future King of England.
Literally all of us are aware of that. Right. Okay, if you somehow have written the correct answer, Mayor Pete, we'll be able to end somewhere above rock bottom. Let's see. You wrote, well, this can't be Alan Morrison. Are we getting this? That's correct.
Of course. How could I not know our real life Mr. Finch? For in the brightest blazes of injustice, Ken, Professor Morrison sits in the shadow of a new beginning. America needs good men like him and good institutions to preserve and make more perfect our union. And that's why I have come here today to announce that
Okay. That's all we have for tonight, folks. I hope you've enjoyed this very special episode of Jeopardy. Please continue to stay safe in your homes. Time is a flat circle at this point, and if you need me, I'll be crying in the hard lounge.
Duty. breach, cause, damages. Long ago, the four elements of a tort lived together in harmony. Then everything changed when duty was breached. Only the Avatar, master of all four elements, could stop them, but when the world needed him most, he vanished. 100 years passed, and some GW Law students discovered the new Avatar, a former mayor named Rudy Giuliani, and although his cross-examination skills are great, he has a lot to learn before he's ready to prosecute anyone. But I believe Rudy can save the world.
Well, I'm negative too, so let's make my future into mask off.
Glad we all live on our own, you know? Don't have to interact with other people.
Nate, you tested negative, right?
Oh yeah, I just got that thing where, you know, your mask bunches up and bundles your schnoz hairs.
Oh, of course. I know how that goes. Stuff to keep those learned hands away from your face.
See, that was a funny pun, because we're in law school.
Right. Learned Hand was a famous off-quoted judge.
And we love humor, because we're all part of Law Revue. Anyway, how'd y'all do at OCI? I'm thinking of selling my soul to schmuckin' putts.
I haven't decided if I want to dig myself out of crippling debt by working for Fresh Out of Hell and Associates. My other option is with Save the Whales, but that salary would force me to live in an apartment in the Potomac River sewage tracks.
Oof, yeah, that's quite the conundrum. You know, I've also been having trouble.
You tested negative, right?
I swear on Antonin Scalia's grave that I tested negative. I didn't want to freak anyone out here, but I have been having an allergy flare-up recently.
First of all, you know this is a strict living constitution household. And first of all, you know that Lex and I are RBG stance. However, I'm glad you were honest with us.
I mean, as long as we're all on the same page, you know, I just don't want anyone to feel like... Okay, I know what you guys are thinking, but I'm negative too.
Oh, thank goodness. I was starting to get worried.
But I do have smallpox.
As long as it's not COVID.
Who wants guacamole?
Reels just hit a wall. Thought we'd have it all. No cool calls in class. We'd just have to pass. We're told it'd be a breeze. The best part of our degrees. But then Corona hit, and it has gone to shit. They were gonna get so wasted at every bar review. They were gonna get to party before they said adieu. Pandemic economy, thinking about it constantly. The future could be bright, but nothing has been alright since we last were in Lerner. In line at Uptowner, there was food in the hard lounge. Could never find somewhere to sit. I feel bad for one else, but we're still all by ourselves. Cause we had to digitize. It's COVID, COVID, COVID law school life. Where's the skipping to? Go to Tonic. We just got the fountain on the first floor, damn it.
Who knew we'd miss the ins of court coffee?
Whatever happened to outlines, case briefs in the library?
Since we were in Myrner, in line at Uptowner, there was food in the hard lounge. Never find somewhere to sit. I feel bad for one else, but we're still all by ourselves.
Cause we had to digitize COVID, COVID, COVID law school life.
We hate to make it stop. Why can't our professor stop using chalk? We're being cheated of all the free booze.
Please wear a mask, 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 and bring back
Stockton and Lerner, coffee at Uptowner. There was food in the hard lounge, could never find somewhere to sit. I feel bad for one else, but we're still all by ourselves.
Cause we had to digitize COVID, COVID, COVID law school life.
It's been 1 week since you looked at me.
All right then, everyone. Sorry about the delay in getting started. I blame it on the portal, but actually I had a Taco Bell last night. All right, I think you're all muted right now. Anyway, this is a small class, so I figured we'd start off, just go through the roster. I'll make sure everyone's here. Make sure I have your preferred name and pronouns. So going alphabetically, first on my list is a Todd Bangor.
Yeah, I prefer to go by CJ.
Okay, neither of those letters are in your name, but, you know, sure, whatever you're most comfortable with.
It's CJ for Chief Justice. Just an aspiration, I guess, Prof.
All right, Todd. And go fuck yourself. Oh, sorry. Got this was a recorded class. We will fix that later.
Hey, Professor. I'm just going to jump in and introduce myself, as I'm next in the list, and I figured it'd save you the trouble.
Okay, Gunner, just on a factual basis, that isn't correct. I have you last on my list.
Well, Professor, I can go now. It's really okay.
Sure. Go ahead.
Gunner Smith. You had the pronunciation right. Gunner. And my favorite part about being a managing editor at Law Review is
Gunner. Just keeping it simple right now, just sticking to names and pronouns. Oh, okay then. Gunner, I see your hands up.
Maybe more of an office hours question, but that I figured I'd put it in now because we're having a conversation.
So next on my list, I have Rick. It's all the class roster says is just, Rick, you're muted right now.
Sorry about that, Prof. Rick, taking this pass foul, not expecting to unmute again.
Okay, then. Honestly, most reasonable answer so far. Moving right along, Morgan Pepperidge, you can go right ahead.
You seem deeply troubled, Professor. I can see it in your eyes.
What makes you say that?
The reviews, Professor. The reviews from last semester's class. I can see it in your eyes and in your reviews.
I mean, sure, it's been a bit of a difficult year. I don't deny that. I mean...
Your house? All that construction. Terrible timing for a water main break, don't you think?
Who are you? You know what? No. Gunner, I see your hand still up. All getting used to Zoom. I'm guessing you just forgot to put it down after the last question.
Oh, no. I practiced over the summer. I'm fully used to Zoom, but I have sort of a continuous question that I figured I'd leave my hand up the whole semester just so we could be like we're really in person.
All right. Thank you for that, Gunner. You know, band student like you, I'll actually put you in a breakout room to discuss that sort of stuff.
Thanks, Professor. I just came up with that question while I was rereading the second case, and I couldn't help but notice that in the fourth note following the case, several scholars have debated whether...
Morgan, I see you logged in. Can you tell us the facts of this case?
Sorry, Professor. I'm actually fixing a water main break right now. your water main break.
I changed the locks after last time, though. You know what? Crazy times we're in. Ryan, haven't heard from you just yet. What about you? There, Ryan? Oh, I see we've got a chat. Spilled entire bottle of Mountain Dew on my mic. Sorry, bro. No, I wasn't aware this was a 12-year-old gamer's birthday party, but moving on, CJ, I see that you're here. Can you help out your classmates with this case?
Sorry, Prof, my mic isn't working.
But just spoke into your mic. We heard you.
Oh, sorry. I actually meant that my camera isn't working.
Honey, I'm leaving you.
Sorry, class. That was just my husband saying he's leaving to go get some groceries.
Professor, I think that he said that he's leaving you. Like, in general.
No, you just misheard him. It's audio issues.
Professor, just to confirm, are we going to need to know about your husband leaving you for the final? And if that's the case, could we discuss the rationale so that I can apply the...
Nope, that's purely hypothetical situation because it did not happen, will not be on the final. Nothing to worry about there.
But hypothetically, if it were on the final?
If it were on the final, we've already gone into very strange territory. You don't have to worry about anything at that point. Welcome back, class. Just 2 weeks more of this experience. So let's press on so you can get your pass, I can get my pension. One of you can leave me a review saying something like, his embittered legal realism was approaching. That said, too much reading. Now, I tried to put together a bit of a visual aid to help explain this portion of the law. So can everyone see this chart okay?
Yep, Prof, you're coming in loud and clear. What key are we in?
Sorry. Key? Professor, board is blurry. Did you even type that from there? You know what? Okay, just like my memory of last night, bar review was tight. Wait, are they still having bar review? Is that even legal?
Sorry, Prof, I'm having a hard time hearing you. Can you speak up?
I have said absolutely nothing of relevance.
Sorry, Professor, my speakers are really crumbly. Can you start from the top of the case?
I have not even gotten a chance to get to the top of the goddamn case, Morgan.
Professor, you keep walking away from the mic. I really need you to come forward if you wouldn't mind so I can hear what you're saying.
You know what? Go to hell. Go to hell, all of you. I'm pretty sure I am already there. But if you continue to make your tuition payments, you all pass anyway. Okay.
Pack your bags, you're going to OCI!
For a long time, we've been working straight through law school.
For some smart students, we feel a lot like damn fools.
Like the pounding beat, our loan receipt ain't easy to ignore.
Hey, think of instead a firm worth working for.
Huh?
That's what I said, a firm worth working for. I pass the fucking bar.
My firm will marvel at my strength, adore my ADR.
I don't care about the when or where or what my day's like. It all depends on what the pay's like.
Cash, stocks, bonus, ooh.
For the local firms, thought you were quite the charmer.
And I'll bet the big firms love a notes editor.
You can guess what we have missed the most since we began this law school chore. What do we want?
A firm we're working for.
My firm will think I have no faults, that I'm a major find.
How about public interest for a change? We'll help folks all the time?
Nah.
My gunner ways and clinic days all made me braver. She thinks she'll be a litigator.
I've a firm back home that's unlike any other.
Yeah, the only firm that hire her is her mother's.
But when we interview here in D.C., a line up at our door.
What do we want?
A firm worth working for.
Wish that I had
a firm worth working for.
Yeah, Covington told us that even though we're all remote, our summer associateship is going to be a full immersive experience. We're all planning on turning our Zoom backgrounds into cute little virtual party squares. I think I'm going to use a photo of myself from Kim Kardashian's birthday party.
So you're planning on placing a picture of yourself behind a video feed of yourself?
Well, they have to remember me somehow.
It's all virtual. They won't.
Ugh, David. I'm getting another call. I will call you back.
Please don't.
This is Alexis Rose, future Esquire.
Hey, Alexis. This is Perry Katz calling from Covington and Burling. I regret to inform you that the Summer Associate Program has been canceled. We'll be sending you a severance package of about $10,000 and a non-disclosure agreement regarding cancellation of the program and regarding the phone call.
No.
Bye.
No. That means I have to do public interest. This is the little bit Alexis I have left. With whom do I have the pleasure of putting me out of my misery?
My darling Alexis, I'm afraid this pandemic has fangoriously embedded a swarm of wasp hatchlings in your abdomen. You sound like Roland after one beer too many.
Mom, I have been demoted to the worst public interest firm. They don't pay me, and they specialize in defending victims of Instagram influencer fraud. All of my friends have been implicated. That's a conflict of interest.
Alexis, honey, this is your father. Now I know you're frustrated, but I'm sure your severance package from Covington is more than enough for your summer expenses, and then some.
Dad, duh! How am I supposed to afford a VIP ticket to the new Fire Festival? Jonathan Turley is going to be there reading his impeachment testimony backwards.
Alexis, now what are we to do for your ostensibly dire circumstances? I know you're quite aware of the similarly destitute situation on our home front.
Ugh! You two are useless. Besides, I'm getting another call. Hello?
Hi there. Is this Alexander Rose?
No, this is Alexis.
Yeah, whatever. Alexander, this is Robin from Vera Wang's Office of General Counsel. We're offering you the Assistant General Counsel position. Comes with full benefits, company car, 90% discounts on all the company's signature pieces. You know, the works, like we discussed previously. So, would you like to accept?
What's your policy on Zoom backgrounds?
Hey, everybody. Welcome to this Know Your Rights seminar.
I'm here today to teach you all a few basic legal concepts because we all love civil engagement and following the rules. Well, actually, as the judge explained, you're all here because you signed a petition to build an electric fence around the homeless shelter. Yeah, and I'm here because I submitted all my exams as Word docs instead of PDFs. So, anyway, let's get started. You see...
Excuse me. Hello. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. Hi. So, let's say, hypothetically, I have a friend, and she has an assistant who needs a mask when she goes grocery shopping, clothes shopping, window shopping for me. For my friend. Does my friend really need to pay for that mask?
Whoa. What you just said there is what we in the law like to call an issue. And I just spotted it.
Okay, but my friend, does she need to pay for the stupid mask?
Right, issue spotted. Respondeat superior. An employer is liable for the acts of their employees when the employee is acting within the scope of their employment. So, your assistant...
My friend's assistant.
Right, your friend's assistant probably can ask for a mask whenever she's doing something specifically for you. The scope of her employment.
Is it within the scope of her employment when she stops to buy lemonade from the cancer kits? That's right, Janine. I know what you've been doing.
Well, we should all probably still be wearing masks right now.
Except there's this thing called freedom.
Yeah, there's also this thing called the police power of the state. You see, the government, it has...
Excuse me, which government are we talking about? Because my government isn't controlled by pedophiles and pizza parlors. Why do you think the pepperoni slices are getting smaller each year? They're from the children.
Issue spotted. You see, you might be thinking of state law. There are two sets of laws. You have your little state laws, and you have your big federal law.
Okay, Mr. Hotshot, Mr. Big Words, Mr. Syllables, you're trying to tell me that there's more than one law? Get real. I know the law. I know the truth. Jet fuel can't melt the levees in New Orleans.
Yeah, okay, yeah, right. This is a federalism issue. So you see, you have Louisiana, and then you have the big federal government of the United States. Kind of does look like a pizza pie.
He just, I knew it.
And all the state governments are the little pepperonis.
Yeah, that's why they're so little, like the children.
Fuck, I messed up the pepperonis and pie in my con law exam.
Gail, that's enough.
My name is Craig.
I have a real problem. My name is Belair Trustfunderson, fifth generation law student. My dad owns the building, and I just have to ask, are professors legally allowed to ignore my raised Zoom hand?
Wait, how did you get in here? This is a session for Karen. So you a law student?
Like, Zoom added that feature for a reason. When I raise my Zoom hand like so, I'm actually raising my real hand because I have a very important question. Okay, more of a comment than a question, but it's so very important.
That's right. Gunners are just another form of Karen.
They are legally obligated to answer my questions. I'm literally paying their salary.
Issue spotted. Why don't you just ask after class?
Well, Jillian, because then I can't piggyback off of Aaron.
Okay, why don't you just go to office hours?
Because, Professor Fake Names office hours are during my daily vision board sessions.
I'm sorry, your visions? What
right,
are your...
Let me tell you something, Mr. Law. Her visions are constitutionally protected from unlawful search and seizure. Yeah, that's right. I know my Second Amendment.
Yep. And the Second Amendment, that's in the Constitution. That's what makes it constitutional. You want to talk about the feds? You want to talk about pepperoni pies? How about we talk about how you are committing a federal crime, stealing her visions?
Yeah, stop the steal.
But I
Gail, Gail, you are muzzling me. And I don't think my second cousin, Senator Josh Hawley, would be very happy to know that someone in a room my father bought is telling me to go to office hours.
Wait, is Josh Hawley your dad?
Trying to tell me what happens to the pepperoni pies in a pizza parlor.
Trying to tell me how to responder super.
Splendial superior.
Yeah, my dad owns the building. And I own the building then. Which means that you're trespassing and I can evict you.
No.
And, just, Grail, stop. I'm calling the cops.
Don't worry about it, honey. Janine is on it. And I am not reimbursing you for that mask, Janine.
It's so nice to see you all, albeit virtually.
Just so you guys know, if we don't get an in-person happy hour reunion in 2022, I'm going to do my own one-woman law review show.
Good luck. I'm not doing tech for that. I'm fully out.
Oh, I know. This whole virtual Zoom school is driving me nuts. But look on the bright side. No Zoom classes after April.
100%. I don't know about you guys, but I am so ready to be finished.
Yep, same here. Bye.
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 Farewell.
Hey, hey. Bye, bye. Really, at the end for us, we'll see you at reunions and that kind of stuff.